Thanks so much. Hey, it's nice to be back in Switzerland. You might be the greatest of all time. So the summertime is over, unfortunately. But it's been pretty fucking hot around here. I guess that's why I can't stop sweating. Anyway, I wrote a song about summertime. It's about finding love in the summertime. Summertime's a good time to find love. Round about this time, late September, early fall, it's also a good time to end summer love. And if it's not going well, you could be like, this was more of a summer thing. If there's anybody here tonight with someone they'd like to end it with,
another good timing.
Let's make it a night to remember. Even though you came, but I haven't taken up the time to tell you that I had no shame, that I was gonna make you mine. But I let you be who you become. The others wish they could have some. Let them have the bubble gum. But we felt like we're summer in the summertime. On the keyboard. I'm bass, Diego Rodriguez. And Bob Knight on the drums. And please give it up for all of our great crew guys up here doing all the hard work all day. Shingo O'Connor, Will, Derek, Garrett is back. Does it look like I have sunshine coming out of my ass with sitting on top of this thing? We got any soldiers in the house? Soldiers in the house? This goes out to the person in your life you know you can rely on. We all need somebody we know we can call in the middle of the night. We're out in the middle of nowhere. And know that they're going to come pick us up. No questions asked. Y'all ready? Myself. Some of you know a little bit about me, and some of you don't know anything about me. But I'm from a little prison town in New York State. USA. And my father worked at a prison. And he had a really cool name, my dad. In 1948, when my dad was born, he was given a really cool name. He was named John Wayne DeGraw. Wow. Cowboy name. Sort of a Hollywood name. Now I think it's kind of makes me laugh a little bit, because it would be like me naming a son like Brad Pitt DeGraw. Legends of the Fall DeGraw. Anyway, when my father wasn't working at the prison, he was cruising around looking for extra work to make a little more money. And he had this old pickup truck and had one album in it, and that album was always on. It was this old Willie Nelson record. Wow. Never came out of the truck, you know. And he liked to go pick up extra work in that truck. So he'd be mowing lawns or working on houses and cleaning chimneys and shit like that. And as his son, it was always exciting when he'd say, "Hey, you want to go for a ride in the truck?" He'd be like, "Yeah, hell yeah, let's go for a ride in the fucking truck." And you know, after a while though, I realized that he was just using me for my labor. Every time I get in that truck, an hour later, I'd be pushing the fucking lawnmower somewhere. Cleaning up the yard somewhere, you know.
Smart man.
And my mom, she ended up joining the Army because she wanted to go back to college. She didn't have the money for college, so she joined the Army and get a little college money, and she went out, she got her master's degree, and she got a real education. And, yeah, she thought that was pretty cool for a while. And we were all proud of her. But I always thought it was funny because both my parents had ended up in the military at some point in their lives. And I thought that was funny because I know that in 1969, they were at Woodstock together. And they were hippies. So. And I know that because my father loved to tell me about it. And for the first couple of years, he told me, I thought it was pretty cool. And then, after a while, the stories got more adult. And kind of got disgusting a little bit. I was like, "Stop, I don't want to hear anything else about mommy, you know, it's disgusting." He's like, no, one more, let me tell you one more story. And I'm like, no, actually, let's just go for a ride in the truck. But this song right here is about it's about all that. This is how me and my friends, we would blow off steam when we were teenagers because our parents were working so much. This is how we would how we get through. It's called for you. Johnny's got a family of five, and he works for the state. He got the exit and piling high in an old Chevrolet. Willie on the dash playing tunes. Smells like grass cause he's covered in June. Picking up extra cash, mowing lawns with the kids. Church as it kneel down to pray, saying, "Please, Lord, have pity on us, take our troubles away. The seeds that we're planting with you, we hope one day your love will come true. I remember reading and writing that look on his face." So we get high and we ramble, get drunk and we gamble. Teenagers cruising at 75, singing "Sweet Home Alabama." Stay out all day on weekend. Sundays when you're sleeping, nobody's living this planet alive. Might as well end. Yeah, freedom.
crawl. Angry, hungry like everyone else, like you can blow out the can. Stay out all day and weekend. Sundays when you're sleeping. Nobody leaving this planet alive. Might as well enjoy your freedom. Yeah, freedom.
Yeah. This is John Foster.
You guys sound good, damn. Some of y'all sing really, really good. I looked out in the audience, one of you was like, like the voice audition. Yeah. My heartbreak isn't what it used to be. This is just a good song. And as a songwriter, I have my own personal heroes, people I look up to, you know. And I'm a big Beatles fan, so we're going to do a John Lennon song. Everybody hear like old school music? Old school. I like old school. I know the term old school is a relative term. What's old school to me might not be old school to you, and vice versa. For example, my sister has kids, and so I'm Uncle Gavin. And when I say to her kids, when I say, hey, you guys want to hear some old school? They're like, hell yeah, Uncle Gavin, play some 2017. That's not old school. Alright, so this is old school to me, and I just love this song. Let's get down. It goes just like this.
I'm sorry, baby. So this next song is about advice. Has anybody here ever gotten bad advice before? Like worse than bad direction? Is anybody here tonight with the person that gave them bad advice?
Yes!
Fight. Break up with that person. So, I have some basic rules to avoid bad advice. These are my three rules. There are many other rules. This is just three of them. So the first rule is only ask somebody who loves you for the advice. And the second rule is ask somebody older than you for the advice. Unless it's how to use your phone better. It's different. And the third is you have to go up in IQ. Always up in IQ. 5 or 10 points is good. 5 or 10 points up is plenty. 30 points is too many. They won't understand your problems. So this is me asking my father for advice. This song's called Four. I was trying to write a John Denver song and I wrote it. Y'all know John Denver?
Yes!
So this is like a bad John Denver song. It feels like... Now that I've sabotaged myself. Try, but I'm trying. Till I'm in climbing. Oh, I can't seem to talk. Old man, can you help me understand? I'm on this planet, baby, no one else stop. Looking for a dollar, oh, hey, man, looking for a dollar, that's the only thing I know. Just driving home, got a blessing to praise the Lord. Got a blessing to feel our home.
Baby, see how fast I can drive.
definitely deserves a liquor. Thank you so much. So I'm going to take you way back to a year I don't remember. Maybe 2011, maybe 2013. If I knew, I would tell you. But this song was called Where You Are.
Where you are.
So we're going to go back to 2008 now. Does everybody remember what they were doing in 2008? You remember? What were you doing?
Qu'est-ce que tu faisais en 2008?
Does everybody remember what the biggest movie of the year was in 2008?
Plus grand film.
If you don't remember what the biggest movie in 2008 was, then you definitely don't remember what you were doing in 2008. So I was like, I definitely remember what I was doing. Does anyone remember what the biggest movie of 2008 was? Do you want me to tell you?
Yeah.
I have no fucking idea. No clue. But I remember I was supposed to put a record out. And I was worried. I was really worried. Because my first record, I had some hits on that record. Thanks to you, I had hits on that record. Thank you for that. So you made that record a hit, the first record. So I was supposed to put my second record out. I invited a friend of mine over. I said to him, hey man, you want to hear something? He goes, yeah, sure. Yeah. He said, you want to hear my next record? I got to put my second record out. He goes, oh, second record, huh? I said, yeah, man, second record. I gotta put it out. He goes, oh, I don't know, man. I said, what don't you know? He goes, man, you know what they say about the second record? I said, no, I don't know. What do they say about second records?
If you do it, please, yeah.
Everybody's second record sucks. I said, get out of my house. Anyway, try to play it for him. I got lucky with this song right here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
what?
Tonight, you arrested my mind, and you came to my defense.
seeing us live first time. Thank you so much for coming out to give us a try. You know, how many of you have come back before? Thanks for coming back. Thanks for the continued support. It means a lot to me.
Last time I saw you was in New Jersey.
You saw us in New Jersey? Where in New Jersey?
At the State
Theater. Oh, no shit. You're from New Jersey? Are you from out here?
I am.
Thanks for traveling the world, man. New Jersey. You know, I come from down in the valley where I'm disturbed when you're young. They bring you up to do like your daddy done. You know that one?
Yeah.
Me and Mary, we met in high school. I don't know it though. Makes you a very special friend, a lover, family member, whatever. That's a big deal. That's a commitment. And I respect you for showing up. Thanks for showing up tonight. I hope you're enjoying the show today. I really appreciate it. Now, let's do one that you guys might know this one, too. You're going to have to help me sing, though, because my voice is all messed up.
That's a licorice.
I had two options, right? Two options, like cancel the show and be an asshole. Don't want to do that. You got to show up and do your work. You guys came here, right? You guys traveled just like I did. So, I mean, it's a big deal coming out to a show. All right. Maybe you sing this one, because I can.
Thank you.
Chariot car. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all. But spare no bed of roses. Lord, put the crew. I consider it a challenge.
Someone wants